Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. My name is Dr. Khalid Abul Bashar. I would like to welcome you all to my YouTube channel, Molecular Genetics. In this lecture, I'll talk about Hardy-Weinberg Equilibrium, a part of population genetics. As we know that Mendelian genetic cannot be used to describe genetic characteristics of a population. We can only use genetic Mendelian genetics to describe the genetic characteristics and variations in individuals. So here we rely on a new branch of genetics called population genetics. And in this lecture, first I'll talk about a population from a genetic perspective. A population is a group of organisms, group of individuals that belong to the same species. And they live together in a particular environment. They influence each other. And when they mate, these individuals in that population, when they mate, they give a fertile offspring. So for such a population, the characteristics, the genetic characteristics in particular, mainly determined by its genetic composition. So what we mean by the genetic composition of that population, we mean that is the genotypes and the genotypes and the alleles frequency of that population. So what determines the genetic characteristics of population is its genetic composition. And what is the genetic composition? The genetic composition is the genotypes and the alleles of that population. So what are the genes and what are the alleles and these terminologies, genotypes, dominant, recessive, and this and that? Gene is a part of a chromosome, normally part of a chromosome. In that part, the DNA of that part in the chromosome has the important genetic information which determines the synthesis of certain protein. A DNA, a portion, a part of a DNA that is a region in the DNA that is determined or codes for the information necessary for the synthesis of a certain protein is known as the gene. And for every gene, some genes, they have two versions or three or more or one. So some genes are having more than one version. That means when they are expressed, they will give more than two proteins. So in such a case, we call that those versions of the gene, we call them alleles. So the alleles are the versions of the gene. So for example, this is a gene for the color of the eye. This is a gene for the color of the eye. But when we express this gene, this will give a black color of the eye. When we express this gene, this will give a blue color of the eye. So we have two versions. These two versions are called allele. Allele, the version of a gene is known as the allele. We have monoallelic genes that have a single version, and we have biallelic genes which have two versions, and we have polyallelic genes that have more than two versions of that genes. So now we talk about the genotype and phenotype of a genotype and phenotype. If we take, for example, two different person, they have two different color of eyes. And for this one, the color of the eye is black, but this one is blue. So definitely the two characteristics are different, but the gene responsible is the same color of the eye, but this is a version of the gene and this is another version of the gene. So now the genetic makeup, the genetic makeup of a person, if a certain person or organism, the genetic constituents of that individual is known as the genotype. What genes are there in that person? What genes this person is carrying is known as the genotype. Now the physical feature, the color of the eye, the black color of the eye, the shape of the eye, the shape of the eyebrows, the shape of the fingers, the color of the skin, the nature of the hair, all these are features, physical features, the blood groups, all these are features that can be seen or measured. All the physical features that can be seen or measured are known as the phenotype of an organism. So the phenotype is the physical feature, the thing that we can see or measure. This is known as the phenotype, and the genotype is the genetic makeup of an individual. This one, for this individual, the phenotype is the black eyes. For this one, the phenotype is the blue eyes. Now, the genotype is the genetic makeup. This person is carrying two genes, capital B, capital B. And this person is carrying two genes, small b, small b. So, the capital B, capital B are known as the dominant, and the small b are known as a recessive genotype. So why dominant and why recessive? Dominant, the dominant genotype is a genotype when it's mixed through mating with another genotype, it gets expressed and the other one gets suppressed. When this person, for example, get married to another person with a blue eyes, the children will all have the black color of the eye. So why? Because the genes are dominant. They dominated the expression of the gene. So the gene were expressed and they prevailed over this one. So that's why these genes, which their phenotype is shown when the person that carry them mate with another person that carry another genotype, this genotype is known as a dominant genotype. The other one, which is suppressed, which is not shown in the children, this is known as a recessive gene. So a recessive is a genotype that is not shown in the offspring, while the dominant is a genotype that is shown in the F1 generation or the offspring. This is we have talked about this in the first Mendelian laws, in the law of dominance. Mendelian law of dominance, we talked about genotype and phenotype in a previous lecture. Now we talk about Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium or Hardy-Weinberg principle. This is a principle that is developed by two physicians. Hardy from England, a mathematician, and Weinberg from Germany, a physician. They developed independently in 1908 a quantitative theory for defining the genetic structure of the population. That theory states the amount of genetic variation in a population, the allelic and the genotypic frequency, will remain constant from one generation to the next in the absence of evolutionary forces. The absence of evolutionary forces is when these conditions are met. That is, the population is very large in size, random mating, it is not a predetermined mating between individuals in the population. That is, the mating, the selection of the one individual choosing another individual for mating is not based on specific characteristics. So it's just randomly, and every individual in that population has a similar chance, the same chance of getting of mating with another individual in that population. So this is known as random mating. Also, mutation. The absence of mutation means a physical change in the genetic structure of the change in the physical structure of a gene. So this change may produce a new allele. So this production of new alleles may affect the equilibrium or the genetic variation in a population. Another thing is the migration. The absence of migration will be a factor that is important for this equilibrium to be achieved. The migration is the movement of individuals from one population to another population, and those individuals will carry with them a new set of alleles that might affect the equilibrium in the genetic variation in that population. Also, random selection is the presence of genotype that will favor the survival and reproduction of those who carry those genotypes, and this will definitely result in a change in the equilibrium from one generation to another, equilibrium of the genetic variation from one generation to another generation. Now, let's take population consists of 15 individuals. Let's say these are 15, 7 of them are P, capital B, capital B, 5 capital B, small b, and 3 small b, small b. So these are 15 individuals. This is a genotype. When we talk about the two genes together, this is a genotype. So this is a genotype of those 5 persons, and this is a genotype for the 3 ones. So this is a genotype. What about the phenotype? When we talk about a single circle like this, one only, this is a phenotype. This is an allele. This is an allele. So this is a genotype, and this is the allele. So the genotype that is given by the presence of capital B, capital B, this will be a black eye, because this is the dominant. Capital B, capital B will give a black eye. So those 7 people will be carrying, they will be showing a black color of the eye. Those 3, they carry the recessive genotype, which is a small b, and this is shown as a blue color of the eyes in those 3 people. The 5, the other 5, they will carry a mixture of both. This is called a heterozygous. Heterozygous. One is dominant, the other one is recessive, and the phenotype will be black because the dominant gene will prevail. The dominant gene will be expressed, and this will be suppressed. So those people will be carrying a black eyes. So now, if we take all this population of 15 individuals, if we take all the alleles of this population, all the alleles, and we put them together in a collection without assigning any allele to any individual, this is known as a gene pool. So the gene pool is a collection of all alleles in a population without assigning any allele to any individual. So this is the gene pool. Now let's see how we can calculate the genotypic frequency and the allelic frequency based on the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. A genotypic frequency can be calculated using this formula, that is number of individuals with a given genotype in the population divided by the total number of individuals in that population. For example, if you are talking about this genotype, those who are carrying the capital B in the population, if you want to calculate the genotypic frequency, the genotypic frequency of the capital B will be 7, the number of those who are carrying this certain genotype divided by the total number of individuals, 7 divided by 15, and it's equal to so and so. This is the genotypic frequency. Now the genotypic frequency for the capital B small b will be 5 divided by 15, and so on. So this one way to calculate the genotypic frequency of a population. What about the allelic frequency? Allelic frequency, we are talking about the alleles. So what is the allelic frequency of, for example, what is the allelic frequency for the small b? Small b. So small b, the allelic frequency for that can be calculated by number of copies of a given allele in a population divided by the total number of alleles in that population. So when we talk about this allele, the b, small b, so now the number of small b's in the population, the number of alleles is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so 11. So we have 11 small b's, and the total number of population, we have 15, so we have 30 alleles. So we have 30 alleles and 11 b. So what is the allelic frequency for the small b? This is 11 divided by 30, and this will give us the allelic frequency. So this how we calculate the allelic frequency, how we calculate the genotypic frequency. Hardy-Weinberg, they gave the probability, the chance, the frequency for a dominant allele. They gave it the letter small p, and they gave the recessive allele, the frequency of a recessive allele, as a small q. So if we are talking about the allelic frequency of the p, this means the allelic frequency of the b, capital b, this is indicated by the letter p, and the allelic frequency of the letter small b, this is indicated by the letter q. So q, p, small p, means or indicate the dominant allele frequency, the dominant allele. And it is Q indicate the recessive allele frequency. If you are talking about the recessive allele, then we will use the Q. And if you are talking about the dominant allele, we will use the P. Now, how Hardy and Weinberg drive their equation for, these are the equation for allelic frequency and genotypic frequency. For example, if I ask a person blindfoldly without looking to select one circle of these circles, for example, if we have 15 blue circles and 15 black circles, if we have 15 and 15 blue and black circles put together, and if I ask a person to just without looking to the collection, just select one circle, and the odd that the circle he selected to is B is half, and so selection of a B circle, selection of a black circle is the probability of selecting that black circle will be half or 50%. So it's a 50% chance, because we have a 15 black and 15 blue. So the probability of selecting a black circle will be 50%, and the probability of selecting a blue circle will be 50%. So a black circle, which is a capital B, that is P, and the blue circle, which is a small b, recessive, that is Q. So a black circle is allelic frequency of a dominant, and the blue circle is the recessive allele. So this is a dominant allele, this is a recessive allele. So this is indicated by a P, and this is indicated by the Q. So now the probability of selecting a P, and the probability of selecting a P is 50%, and the probability of selecting a Q is a 50%. So 50%, that is 0.5, half. 50% is half, so it is 0.5, and 50% for the Q is half. So half plus half is equal to 1. So the probability always equal to 1. The probabilities of the sum of all probabilities is equal to 1. So the sum of all probability of selecting a P or selecting a Q is equal to 1. So what he gave, he said that Hardy-Weinberg, they said that a probability of selecting from a population, a probability of selecting a dominant allele plus the probability of selecting a recessive allele will equal to 1. That is the frequency, the allele frequency of P, the allele frequency of a dominant allele, and the frequency of the recessive allele, the frequency of a dominant allele, plus the frequency of a recessive allele will always equal to 1. So now, what about the genotype, the genotype frequency? Now we said the genotype is both. What is the chance of I select two black circles, like one black and the other one is black, if I was given the chance to select two times, twice? So the chance of selecting the P, the black one, and putting my hand again and selecting a black circle, this will be P, because the chance of selecting one black circle is P. The chance of selecting one black circle, one dominant, is P. And the chance of selecting one blue circle is Q. So the chance of selecting two black circles will be P into P, because this is a multiplication, probability rule of multiplication. So the chance of selecting in two times, if I put my hand in that collection of alleles, and I selected two circles, what is the odd of that two selected circles were black? This will be P into P, P multiplied by P. So P multiplied by P is equal to P square. What is the chance of selecting two blue circles? The chance of selecting two blue circles will be two Q's. The first is Q, And the chance of selecting the other one is other Q. So Q multiplied by Q, Q multiplied by Q. That is Q into Q. Q into Q is Q squared. What is the chance of selecting one black and the other one is blue? This will be a chance of selecting black is P multiplied by the chance of selecting blue is the Q. So blue, black multiplied by the blue. That is the dominant multiplied by the recessive. But here we have two chances. The first chance is selecting the first ball being black and the second one being blue. This is one. And the other one, the other situation is the first ball will be a blue and the second one will be a black. So we have two situations. So the genetic frequency of a population will be the probability of selecting a dominant allele, dominant genotype will be P square plus the probability of selecting a heterozygous will be 2PQ, and the probability of selecting a recessive genotype will be Q square. Now let's go for an example to see how we apply the equilibrium. The B, capital B is the dominant allele and small b is the recessive allele in our example. So P is the frequency for B and the Q is the frequency for B, small b. This is the frequency for the dominant and this is the frequency for the recessive, as we have said, dominant and the recessive. So now the allelic frequency, if we were asked to calculate the allelic frequency of the allelic frequency of the B and the allelic frequency of the Q. So the allelic frequency, the frequency of the dominant allele in that population is equal to the number of the number of the alleles divided by the number of the total number of the alleles in the population. The number of the alleles, certain alleles. We are talking about the P here. P means a capital B, the dominant. The number of dominant allele. Number of dominant allele is the black one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 19. So we have 19 allele which are dominant allele divided by 30, the total number of alleles, 30 equal to 0.63. So the allelic frequency for the dominant allele is 0.63. The allelic frequency for the recessive allele, which is Q, that is 11, the number of the alleles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the blue ones are 11. 11 divided by 30, which is 0.037. We can also calculate the Q by we know that P plus Q equal to 1. So if we know the P, that means Q is equal to 1 minus P. That if we know the P is 0.63, and we want to know the Q, that is 1 minus 0.63 and equal to 0.37. Now the genotypic frequency, this is the allelic frequency, the alleles. Now the genotypes, PB, P, small b, capital B, small b. So the genotype frequency, the dominant genotype frequency, this one is equal to P square, as we have said. This is for the genotype for the dominant genotype. This is a frequency for the dominant genotype. So the dominant genotype is capital B, and the P square is the frequency for this genotype. And P square means, now we know what is P from the allelic frequency. The P is 0.63. So the P square is 0.63 square and equal to 0.397. So this genotype, the frequency of this genotype in the population is equal to 0.397. What about the genotype for this genotype, the frequency for this genotype? The frequency for this genotype is Q square. And the Q square, we know the Q is 0.37 from the previous calculation of allelic frequency. Now the Q square is equal to 0.37 square, and this is equal to 1.37. What about the frequency of a heterozygous genotype. The heterozygous genotype, the frequency is 2 into P into Q. This is 2 into 0.63 into 0.37 and equal to 0.466. And if we added all these values to each other, this will result in this will be added to give us 1. So this plus this plus this, the addition of all these values will give us 1. So P square plus 2PQ plus Q square will give us 1, and this plus this plus this will give us 1. So this is how we can calculate the allelic frequency and the genotypic frequency. Here we can say that 39.7% of the population are carrying the this genotype, and 13.7% of the population are carrying this genotype, and 46.6% are carrying this genotype. Now let's see some problems. The first problem: if 80% of the population is born with severe form of sickle cell anemia, that is carrying this genotype SS small s small s, what is the percentage of the population will be more resistant to malaria because they are heterozygous capital S small s of the sickle cell gene? Now let's rephrase the question again. If 80% of the population were SS, they're having a sickle cell anemia, that is a small s, and what is the heterozygous, what are the carrier of the sickle cell gene? So what is the carrier, the frequency of the, or the percentage of the carriers in that population? Now we know the individual with the disease, small s, now we want to know, calculate the individual with the heterozygous with the capital S, small s, the carriers, or those who are resistant to malaria because of this gene, this genotype. So this is a recessive or dominant? This is a recessive, because dominant means normal, because this is a dominant is present. When we talk about a disease, normally the gene that are present in the disease are the recessive ones. So the SS is, the frequency of SS is 80%. It is given in the problem, 80%, sorry, 8%. 8% of the population are carrying the SS. So 8% means 0.08. And since SS is the mutation from the gene, the mutation form of the gene, then it is the recessive genotype. So SS is the recessive genotype. It's not the dominant genotype. That means the frequency of SS is 8% equal to 0.08. 8% means 8.08, and this is a frequency for the recessive genotype. And we know that the frequency for recessive genotype is Q square. So Q square is equal to 0.08. We know that the Q square is the frequency for recessive genotype. And now we know the recessive genotype is 0.08. So Q square is equal to 0.08. And what we want the genotype for the heterozygous, capital S, small s. So let's get the Q from Q square. Q is equal to the root square, the root of a 0.08. The root of 0.08 will give us a Q, because we know Q square. So we put this under the root, and we put this under the root. This will give us the Q. So Q is equal to the root of 0.08 equal to 0.28. So Q now is equal to 0.28. Now we have to get the P. Now we know the Q. What is the P? We know that P plus Q is equal to 1. So P is equal to 1 minus Q. That is 1 minus 0.28 equal to 0.72. So P is equal to 0.72, and Q is equal to 0.28. Now what is the genotype, the frequency for the genotype SS? This is a heterozygous. So the frequency of the genotype SS is equal to, the frequency for heterozygous genotype is equal to 2 multiplied by P multiplied by the Q. So equal to 2 into P 0.72 into Q 0.28 equal to 0.40. So the frequency for this frequency for this heterozygous genotype is equal to 0.40. So he asked about the percentage of population with this genotype. This means that is 40% of the population will be resistant to malaria because they are heterozygous SS. So this is the answer for this equation, for this problem. Now let's see the second problem. The allele Y, small y, occurs with a frequency of 0.7 in a population of albino rats. If we have population of albino rats, this allele occurs with a frequency of 0.7. Give the frequency of genotype capital Y and capital Y small y. This is homozygous dominant and heterozygous. Now we are asked to give the frequency of a genotype. We have the allele frequency of Y. So the allele frequency of Y is equal to 0.7. And Y is the recessive allele. This is the allele Y occurs with a frequency of 0.7. And we know that is the dominant allele is expressed at the capital letter. So the Y is the recessive allele. Therefore, Q, which is the frequency of Y in the population, is equal to 0.7. Q is the frequency of the recessive allele. And the frequency of the recessive allele is 0.7. So Q is equal to 0.7. And P, now we need to get the P. P is equal to 1 minus 0.7. P plus Q equal to 1. And P equal to 1 minus Q. So P equal to 1 minus 0.7 equal to 0.3. So now P is equal to 0.3 and Q is equal to 0.7. Therefore, the frequency of capital Y, this genotype, is P square. Now we know P. And we know the frequency for the dominant genotype is P square from the equation. Frequency of the dominant genotype is P square. So in this case, the frequency of this genotype is P square. And we know P. So P is 0.3. So 0.3 square is 0.09. And the frequency for heterozygous is 2 into P into Q. 2 into P into Q. So the frequency of capital Y small y will be 2 into P into Q. So 2 into 0.3 into 0.7 equal to 0.42. So he's asking about the frequency for the dominant allele, dominant genotype is this, and the frequency for heterozygous genotype is this. The last problem is, for example, if 16 of a population is unable to taste a chemical substance called phenylthiocarbamide. This is PTC. A chemical has a Peter test. That is 16% of a population, they have some mutation that they are unable to taste this substance. While then these non-tasters are recessive for the tasting gene. So 16%, they are a recessive. They're having a recessive gene which makes them unable to taste this chemical compound. Now he's asking, what is the percentage of individual in the population that are tasters? We have 16% of the population are untasters, non-tasters. So the population of the rest of the population will be the tasters. So 16 are non-tasters, so the rest will be the tasters. That means 100 minus 16 will be 48%. So 48% directly, 48% of individuals in the population will be tasters. The second question is, what is the frequency of dominant and recessive alleles? Now, the frequency of dominant and recessive alleles. Now, we're talking about the alleles. So, a P square, we don't know P square, and we don't know the heterozygous genotype frequency. This is 2P into Q. This is also, we don't know. But we know the Q square. Q square is the a frequency of we are talking about a population. We are not talking about allele here. So we're talking about population, 16% of the population. That means he's talking about the genotype. So 16% of the population having a genotype for the recessive genes, so a Q square. So this 16% is the Q square. 16% means 0.16. So Q square is equal to 0.16. Now Q is equal to the root of 0.16 and equal to 0.4. So the Q is equal to 0.4. Now we want the P. P is equal to 1 minus Q, equal to 1 minus 0.4, equal to 0.6. So now we have the point, now we have the P and we have the Q. Have the P and we have the Q. Therefore, the P square is equal to this one, 0.6 into 0.6, 0.6 square. So equal to 0.36. So what is the frequency of dominant allele? Frequency of dominant allele, which is a P square, dominant allele, the frequency of dominant allele. If you're talking about the frequency of dominant allele, now dominant allele, we are talking about the allele, so we are talking about the P, only P. So the frequency of dominant allele is equal to 0.6, the P. And the frequency of recessive allele is equal to 0.4, recessive alleles, which is a Q, 0.4. And this is 0.36 is equal to, this is the a dominant genotype, the P square. So now what is the percentage of population that are heterozygous for the trait? Heterozygous. So now we have to get the first the frequency of heterozygous, 2 into P into Q, percentage of the heterozygous. So the frequency of heterozygous genotype is equal to 2 into P into Q. This is 2 into 0.6 into 0.4, equal to 0.048. Now he's asking about the percentage of heterozygous. Percentage of population with a heterozygous trait is equal to 48%. 48%. So these are how we apply the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium to calculate the different frequencies. Now Hardy-Weinberg is a useful indicator of a genotype frequencies within a population, genotype and allelic frequencies within a population, and whether these frequencies are based on a valid definition of alleles or randomly mating sample. Actually, the use of Hardy-Weinberg, it's hardly that we get these conditions met. It's normally when we do a research, it's either the population is not very large or there is predetermined mating, or mutation is always there, migration, you cannot control the migration of individuals, also natural selection. So most of these conditions will not be met. So what is the use of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium then? Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium is used as a control. For example, it is used in the human genetic studies when it's used as a guide to data quality, to see if the data is of a good quality or not in the genetic studies. That is comparing the observed genotype. Now we know that is the we can calculate the expected. We can calculate in the, if we know this is the expected. Now all what we did, we expect that in this population, since 16% are non-testers, we expect that the heterozygous percent will be 48. So this is what we expect. Now we can compare the expected with the observed, our results, the results that we get through our research practicals. So comparison between the observed frequencies with the expected, which we can get through application of this equation, will give us an idea about how good our data is, the quality of data is. For example, if the genetic markers that are under study are not in Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, if our observed result totally different from the expected result, that means conventional statistical analysis cannot be performed for that data. So this is one of the application of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium. That is, if you are studying some genetic variation in a population, and we did the practical part, and we studied the and we got all the results for the frequency of an allele, the frequency of a genotype for that variation, and everything we've got. And then we do the mathematical part for Hardy-Weinberg, and then we compare using, for example, statistical method like chi-square test to compare what is expected and what is observed. Our result with what we expect when we use Hardy-Weinberg. If there is a huge deviation from these between these two results, now the statistical conventional statistical analysis cannot be used. Also, in the case of in the case control studies, genetic association studies, in the case control genetic association studies, if there is a significant deviation from the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium, this will indicate that genotyping genotyping error has occurred somewhere. So a deviation from Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium will give us an indication of how good our results is. This is in short of how we can use the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium in our research. Thank you so much for listening, and goodbye.